Oh, it's September 30th. It's time for Watcher Weekly.
It's Wednesday, and it's time for Watcher Weekly.
Welcome to Watcher Weekly, presented by Breather, a show where we kick back, chat, and answer your guys' questions to the best of our ability.
As always, if you'd like to submit questions to Watcher Weekly, you can by the C tab, or get out of the We Are Watcher, yeah. Facebook.com/Watcher Entertainment.
Yeah.
Patreon.com/Watcher.
Yeah.
YouTube.com/Watcher Podcast. WeAreWatcher.tumblr.com.
TikTok, we are Watcher, but who knows?
TikTok Watcher, yeah.
Are we jumping on Triller? Is that what the kids are doing now, or what? What's going on with that?
Wait, is there a TikTok alternative? What were you saying?
Yeah, some of the top TikTokers are jumping ship right now and going to Triller.
Shane, as a top TikToker, are you jumping ship?
I'm going down with the ship.
You going to Trill Town?
Remember in that one Pirates of the Caribbean movie when Tom Holland is Tom Holland?
No.
Okay, I'm thinking of Tom Hollander then. Tom Hollander, he's in that one Pirates where the ship is just like exploding around him, you know? That's me. And TikTok is the...
Or the band from the Titanic. I see you more as the band though, because I could see you saying something like, "It's been a pleasure talking with all of you."
Yeah, but I'd say, "Let's fucking rock, boys."
Anyway, today is our big announcement day. Last week we teased the announcement with an announcement of the announcement.
The announcement.
That's right.
And last week I was in low quality video jail. I apologize. I've got my stuff under control this week. It's not going to happen again.
I certainly hope so. Let's get into these announcements though. Puppet history, I think you should take that one, Shane.
Season finale this week. What a time to be alive.
What's it about?
I don't think we can still say it. It's about the
Wow, you reverse course mid-sentence.
Hey, also, do you live in America? What a time, huh? There's an election coming up. Please make sure you're registered to vote. There's a handy-dandy resource in the description below. Check your registration status. If you're already registered, check it again.
Tell your parents to vote.
Talk to your friends, see if they're registered. Have a plan. Can you vote early? Where? Find out.
Click the link to find out. It's very easy. Offer state-by-state guidelines. You have no excuse, essentially. It's a very important election. That does it for announcements. Let's move on to questions. And like I said, we'll move on to that.
So that wasn't the announcement. We just did announcements, though.
No, the bit.
No, there's teasing. There's a big announcement later.
Steven, get with the program, man. We have a big announcement later, and that's gonna come after the questions. And it's so big, we can't even put it in the normal announcement.
These announcements were like this, though the voting one was pretty important. So that was like this. Put that out one later. It's still not more important than the voting thing, but it's like a hot air balloon almost, you know?
Yeah. These are just the little snacks, like the little finger food you get at a party. The main course is gonna come
These
later.
Are like Triscuit crackers, and then that's like a hot air balloon that you could eat.
Yeah.
All right, now let's get to questions. I'll pull them up on my phone here. Gosh, I can't find anything on this thing. It's very unorganized.
You know, Shane, it sounds like you could use a service of some sort.
You know what? I absolutely could. And that reminds me, we've got a sponsor this week, AnyTrans. Have you heard of AnyTrans?
I haven't. Tell me about it.
I'd like to thank them for sponsoring today's episode. AnyTrans is your one-stop data manager for your iPhone. I don't even know how to use it. It's so confused. What's going on here? This is a mess. I don't know about you guys, but with everything going digital these days, if I lost all of my precious photos of Obi or any of my files on this phone, I would be devastated.
Did you lose photos of me?
I mean, those I care less about than my kitty cat photos, but I do also care about my Ryan photos, obviously.
Okay.
Thankfully, with AnyTrans, I can manage, backup, and transfer all of my data.
In a fun and easy way?
Yeah, I would argue it's pretty fun and easy.
In fact, it's so fun and so easy that you can have a full-way transfer between all of your devices. MacBook, iCloud, iPhone. You even have an iPod from the 2008? Use that. Freely transfer content all across all your different platforms for free. And without erasing existing data.
Ooh.
I like that.
So don't worry about losing those puppet songs.
Also, along with AnyTrans, there is a little contest that they're putting on. They're encouraging all of you to tweet out your favorite or most touching song lyrics with the hashtag #RememberWithAnyTrans. And then they'll choose one winner. The prize is a pair of AirPods and a one-year subscription to Apple Music. So once again, share your most memorable song lyrics on either Twitter, Facebook, or Instagram with the hashtag #RememberWithAnyTrans. and they'll pick one winner, and they'll announce it on October 11th on their socials on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram to see if you guys won the contest.
Well, that's been fun. I think it's time we got into the chill zone, huh? Or wait, no, sorry. We've been in the chill zone.
We never did the chill zone.
No, we did. We were talking about some bullshit.
Hey, there's anything chiller than any trends. You tell me. There's not.
It's
oh, wait, the sponsor's done. Sorry.
Too much now. Let's get into some questions.
As always, you could hear more of these Patreon questions on the extra version of the show, Watcher Weekly Plus, exclusive to Patreon. Anyways, Joanna McKinnon says, is there a particular fashion trend from the past you'd love to see come back? Personally, I'm trying to single-handedly revive go-go boots. Don't know what those are.
Yeah, wait, what are go-go boots?
Is it like Inspector Gadget?
Yeah, they are the tall ones. Okay, go-go boots.
Yeah, go-go
boots. I thought these were in style.
They're not Inspector Gadget. I just heard that joke. It was very funny.
Yeah, these are very Austin Powers, these boots. Definitely not something that I would try to revive personally, but I support it nonetheless.
You know what I...
Oh, go ahead.
You go? No, go ahead.
You go.
Take it, Ryan.
No, Steven, take it away.
Ryan, go ahead.
Go, Ryan. Go, boots.
Go, Steve.
go, Steve.
It's fine. I'm used to being run over by you guys, so don't worry about it.
I would love for Heelys to come back.
Because
boy, did I love my Heelys. You know, some people were just putting their heels up and kind of like sliding down, but I was actually like actively running while Heelying. And I would Heely around Disneyland. I would Heely around the mall.
I was just gonna say, the Heely kids used to scare me at the mall. They move faster than kids ought to.
And then you have all those dorks that are saying, hey, slow down, no roller skating in the mall.
Hey, you can't do that.
And I would say, eat my dust, loser. And I'd Heely away over to PacSun or something like that.
Rotten.
Of course, PacSun.
Well, why don't we move on to another question?
Okay. Yeah.
For Steven, here's from Sienna Tautry. If you could switch places for one day, who would you rather be, Ryan or Shane? I did not pick this question, but I'm intrigued to know your answer.
That is an interesting question.
I need some more details. Do I get just their body, or do I get their life, or do I get their way of thinking and their spirit?
You just get to sort of don the guise of us.
Okay, because if it was a Freaky Friday situation, I think I would have chosen Shane, because I don't want to know what goes up in the head of Ryan Bergara's over there.
No one wants to know what goes on up here.
He's damaged, bro.
He's not damaged.
That's what his tattoo says.
It's true. I have a tattoo that just says damaged on my lip right here.
Ryan himself has said that his brain is cracked.
It's true. It is cracked. Also, Shane would present like a height advantage as well. Like,
that's
like
very. You could ball!
Different experience.
Look, we make fun of Ryan for his muscle tech, but hey, he shows some results in those hops that he still has.
Dude, I can jump very high.
Bergogo got the hops.
Maybe. I got those Berga boosts.
Bergogo boots.
I got those Bergogo boo boo boost.
Next question. This comes from Xantha5SOS Girl. For Ryan and Shane, have Ryan and the professor considered getting a therapist to work their problems with each other out?
Why is this a question for me?
Yeah, it seems like between me and he who shall not be named. Yeah, we've talked about it a little offline, but he's kind of a hard guy to get a hold of. I'm ready when he is. That's all I'll say about that.
I didn't even know you guys knew each other till recently. He's never even mentioned you.
Yeah, it makes sense.
Thought Sauce says, do you guys have any favorite shows? Would you ever consider doing something besides Watcher Weekly that is released year-round?
Oh. Ooh, year-round. It'd be tough to do something else that's not Watcher Weekly year-round, just from a production standpoint.
Yeah.
I pitched this idea this morning, actually. 1v1, me and Ryan. Audience picks the task, and we just battle it out. And Shane is the judge.
Okay, that's fun.
The reason I chose me and Ryan is because we both have like naturally competitive natures, whereas
Shane crumples under pressure. Let's do one last question here. This comes from Abby the Bee on YouTube. When will we get a Steven show again?
You'll be getting a Steven show soon. It's a cooking show. Pour my soul and my heart and my blood, sweat, and tears into it. It was very difficult. And you know, at the end of Homemade, when we finished filming that, I said, please don't cancel the show. And then by the end of this one, I was like, please cancel the show, please. So we'll see.
I look forward to it. I'm very excited.
Well, that does end it for the Q&A section of this episode. Now we're going to move into the big announcement. You all ready? Should we cue some kind of drum roll or something like that?
Yes. Cue drum roll. It's going. It's rolling.
The big announcement is the Watcherween Spooktacular, everybody. All of October is going to be Halloween themed content. In fact, the last episode of Puppet History that's going up this Friday is spooky.
Intentionally spooky. I knew we'd be ending around Halloween or spooky month, so I picked a real spooky one for the season finale.
So what does that mean for Watcher Weekly? Actually, for the month of October, Watcher Weekly is going to go on a little bit of a break. It's going to come back. Watcher Weekly Plus will still be a thing.
Oh, Steven, it's okay. It's okay.
For you Watcher Patreon members, if you want to get some more Q&A action, still going to be there for the month of October. Before the main show, Watcher Weekly will go on a little bit of a break for October. What's going to go in its place, you might ask? A brand new spooky show.
Huh?
The title of the show is Too Many Spirits.
What?
It's a show where Shane and I talk about spooky ghost stories that you guys submitted to us while getting inebriated on spirits.
Drink responsibly.
Responsibly. We're going to shoot these over the course of one day. There's going to be four different episodes. Each episode, we're going to get a little more disheveled because we're going to be doing it linearly. So that's going to be fun for you guys to see how we progress there as we review your ghost stories.
It's also going to be the first time we shoot in the same vicinity.
That's right.
Have I seen you since March?
You have not seen me, so you guys will get a nice little reunion. I mean, I guess we can't really like hug or anything like that, but we will be in the same area, which will be crazy. Anyways, Too Many Spirits coming to you in October. And as for the Friday show, I do have something.
Hey, whoa, Ryan. Yeah, you're gonna just go over the most important part of the show of Too Many Spirits. Who's providing the spirits here, Ryan? Come on.
Oh, that's true. Steven is going to be our cameraman / bartender, and he's going to be making four different special spooky cocktails with a little Steven Lim spice in them.
Oh, and we should come up with spooky names. Spooky names.
Oh, Steven's
going to
be doing
that,
and that's the best part. Steven is going to be coming up with the names.
If you know anything about Steven and naming things, they're gonna be amazing. Are we calling this like Watcher Ween?
We're calling it the Watcher Ween Spooktacular. Oh, also.
Wait, whoa, hold up, Ryan. As a fan of Watcher, does that make me a Watcher Weenie?
I guess you are a Watcher Weenie.
Is this gonna be a rich new tradition every October? We just really lean
I
into
hope
it?
So. I certainly we
love,
hope so.
We love the creepies, you know?
We love
We're
spooky
creepy guys.
But it's gonna be a very fun show. But also, here's a promo picture from the shoot itself. Pretty good stuff right there. You have that to look forward to on Wednesdays in October for the Watcher Ween Spooktacular event, which will also include a secret Friday show that I have been cooking up in the background.
You might want to stock up on some diapers.
That's right.
Because you're going to be pooping your pants with how scary it is. Some spooky poops.
Anyways, now that we've said that, let's move on to the Patreon shoutouts here.
Yes, let us.
We got a fair amount of them this week because we are going on hiatus for a month. So let's just jump right into it.
Let's dig in. Start it out, Ryan.
Thank you to Salmon Caverndahl, Serene Knight 33, Shannon, Shazbot TKC,
that's his name,
Sky, Stephanie Urban, mm-hmm. Stephanie Kelly, Valanth Flosham, Victoria Fisher, Victoria Schmidt, Whitney Ray Peterson, Whitney Reynolds, William Pinkard, Zobo 420, Phi, just the simple Phi, pretty cool. Brianna.
Thank you, Brianna.
Danny Ramirez, Aaron Vaninsky,
Gina Limps,
Mom!
Kayla.
Is that your mom?
Kayla
yes,
Sneller,
that's my mom.
Keegan B, Marlene Manzano, Meg Murray, Richard Emil Bradley, Sarah Dusenberry.
The Dooster.
Davis, Scott Davis.
Susie. The Kramer of Watcher.
Taylor Sampson and Yesenia Sanchez.
All right, I'm gonna take it over from here. Shout out to Angie Gibson, to Annalisa, to Audrey, to Ben. Thank you, Ben.
Thank you.
Bonnie. Do you think that's Bonnie?
Bonnie.
Like a skeleton? Or Bonnie? Probably Bonnie. Cece Nkwe, Charlie the Chameleon, Christine Saki, Cree Long John, Cross Night Ray, that sounds like a comic book character and it kicks ass, L. Piper, M. Sanchez, thank you. Eric Marin. Oh, Giacomino? Is that how that's pronounced?
Giacomino is pretty cool.
Veltri, Gillian, or Jillian Gonzalez, Hannah Graham, Helen Chin, Lamar, Izzy Z, thank you. Jennifer Corain, Jeremy Kuznier,
thank you.
Jeremy Thomas, thank you.
Yes.
Jessica Williamson, Joel Fussell, Caitlin Brennan, Karini, thank you. Kaylee, thank you. Kebo Crash, Q, Kira, Lexi St. Clair,
you skipped Kelly Wilson.
Oh, sorry, Kelly Wilson. Kelly Wilson, thank you. LF Gibson 3000, who I'm pretty sure is a robot, Leah Michelle, and Lindsay Jennings, thank you.
All right, let's round it out here. We have Luis, thank you. Mark Van Der Zag, thank you very much. Marcus M. Plumley, Marina Zaki, Marissa Tham, Martin Weifenbach, Matthew Lim, Granddad, what are you doing here?
Is it really? No, it's not.
Melia Weibo, Michael Vanderberg, Monica Gomez, Monster King,
Monster
Morgan Perendinia Tiaga, Nelly Argan, Rachel Riley, Rebecca Moore, Roz Martinez, Ryan Davis,
Fellow Ryan,
Ryder, Sarah Douglas, Sienna Hole, Sid, Tesha Davis, The Esoteric, Tyler Lena Fernandez, Wander Baby.
Wander Baby.
That's exactly how Ryan says baby.
It is.
Exactly.
Adrian Hisbrook, Chelsea Sexton, and William Leavitt. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. See you over at the Plus.
Watcher Weekly's taking a little break, but we will be doing the Plus over there. You can track us down over there in the meantime. But Wednesdays are about to get a whole lot spookier, folks.
It's gonna be real fun.
So get excited. Anything else? Oh, you know what? Wait, I can't. There's gonna be a special new Puppet History merch thing with the finale, but you'll have to keep your eyes peeled for it because it's not out yet.
I don't even think I know what it is.
I cannot say. Other than that, I don't think I got any big news. How about you guys? Are we ready to wrap it up here?
I think so, if you don't have any other things to pull out of your hair.
I gotta get a haircut, man.
Oh my goodness.
We'll see you next week with some spookies.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Baby.